NHL fans are worried sick about the possibility of a lockout this fall. But for fantasy hockey managers, it's never too early to start looking ahead to those upcoming drafts. So today I want to provide a little bit of a tip on how to identify those mid to late round sleeper opportunities to grab a goal scorer who might be able to help bolster your lineup up front. Now, when putting together their lists, a lot of folks are going to focus on production from last season. Goals, assists, maybe power play goals, something like that. And you can get led astray there because the ability to put shots on net is pretty consistent from year to year, but goal scoring can vary wildly. And that's because an individual player's shooting percentage can swing from one season to the next. Now, shooting percentage, of course, is the number of goals scored divided by the number of shots that a player puts on net. And again, for an individual forward, typically something like 8 to 12% may be the normal range. But in a good season, a guy might shoot 15, 16, even 17%. And conversely, on the bad end, a guy can shoot 4, 5, 6% or so. And it's not unexpected at all to see those things rebound towards the middle from one year to the next. So here are five guys to look forward to as opportunities to perhaps enjoy a rebound season and allow you to snatch some value in those mid to late rounds. Now, our first is Anaheim Ducks captain Ryan Getzlaff. He experienced a very uncharacteristic drop in production last season. His shooting percentage of 5.9 was the lowest in his career. He should be in the 20 to 25 goal level easily. And a lot of fantasy managers are going to drop him into those, you know, mid-round areas. That may be an opportunity for you to snatch him up ahead of time and grab some real value. Our second opportunity is a guy named Tyler Kennedy. He puts up a ton of shots for the Pittsburgh Penguins, and he experienced a double whammy last season. Not only did he experience a career-low shooting percentage, but he also missed about a quarter of the season due to injury. When you put those two factors together, a fantasy hockey manager is going to look at that and say, well, he only scored a certain number of goals last season, but he's a guy who should consistently be up in that 20 to 25 goal range over the course of the season, and he actually has potential to do even more than that. Our third value opportunity is Martin Hanzel of the Phoenix Coyotes. Much like Kennedy, he suffered from that double whammy of missing time due to injury and suffering a career low shooting percentage. A rebound in either or both of those areas should get him back up to that 20, maybe even 25 goal mark. Number four, we're going to talk about Blake Como. He was traded from the New York Islanders over to Calgary last season. And again, experienced a very, very low shooting percentage, only 3.6 across the entire season. That's only about a third of what he typically does. So even a modest rebound should get him back up to that 20-goal mark. You know, and again, if you can pick a 20-goal, 40-point type of guy in the later rounds of your draft, that can provide tremendous value. The last guy we're going to talk about is Dustin Penner of the Los Angeles Kings. Now, again, here we have another guy who he only scored 7 goals and added 10 assists. So he's going to be plummeting down the depth charts for most fantasy hockey managers. But he only played 65 games last season. And again, another guy who experienced a very low shooting percentage. If he gets a rebound back into the mid-range, he could be easily another guy who gets up above 20, 25. And of course, we've seen him hit the 30-goal mark before. So that's not entirely unexpected. So there you have it, five guys who could all provide outstanding value in the mid to late round selections of your fantasy hockey draft. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'll be back with more fantasy hockey tips and updates as we prepare for the upcoming 2012-2013 NHL season. I'm Dirk Hoge of On the Forecheck.